is that?
It's called a star puzzle. It's basically impossible to figure out. You have to put all of the pieces back together to form a perfect star. But the origin of it is kind of a romantic tale. There was this young prince who wanted to win the heart of the fairest maiden in the land. So he climbed to the top of the tallest tower in the kingdom, and he caught a falling star for her. Unfortunately, he was so excited that he dropped it and it smashed into all of these pieces. So he frantically put it back together again to prove his undying love to her, and he succeeded, and they lived happily ever after.
That doesn't make any sense.
What do you mean?
You can't catch a falling star. It would burn up in the atmosphere.
Yeah, but it's not literal, Reid. It's a fable.
But there's no moral. Fables have morals.
Okay, so it's just a romantic little story. And the point is, it's basically impossible to do because you have to take all of those pieces and fit them together exactly. There's a lot to hate about you, Dr. Reid.
Play poker with him sometime.
Try playing chess with him.
Or go.
2.9 miles west of here, which means if they drove the speed limit, they got here in 30 minutes or less.
So, how long is it going to take you to get in that ditch?
Get in that ditch? I got shot in the knee, remember? My doctor says I'm not allowed to do any climbing.
It's a ditch.
New boots, huh? Italian leather?
Yeah, what can I tell you? So, from here, I can be seen by any passing vehicle.
And I can't.
So she was dumped at night.
Must have.
He drives up, dumps the body, job done, he leaves.
I don't think so.
What?
All five victims were found posed in the fetal position with their right arm palm up, left arm palm down.
Remorse?
Or staging.
To look like what?
Like they're asleep.
Do you have any ideas why?
No.
Well, I guess there is a first time for everything.
Hey, Rossi, I'm gonna need a little bit of help getting out of this ditch. Rossi? Rossi? Hey, I got it.
Listen, I appreciate you guys coming down.
You know, contrary to popular belief, decapitation is not that easy.
You don't often hear popular and decapitation in the same sentence.
Oh, God.
Definitely in the right place.
Guys, just breathe through your nose like normal. Smell is the weakest sense. In a few more minutes, you won't even notice it.
What about the taste?
I think that's in your head.
Hey, have a good weekend, JJ. Sorry.
There goes my beach house rental.
And my non-refundable sin to win weekend in Atlantic City.
Sin to win?
Yeah. And I always win big.
I didn't have any plans.
This heat is brutal.
You know, it isn't so much the heat as it is the humidity.
At some point, it doesn't matter how you look at it. It all sucks.
Your love, right before he kills them.
Hey, have you read The Illustrated Man?
Nope.
Oh, it's amazing. It's a collection of short stories by Ray Bradbury based around the metafictive device of a man who's covered in tattoos drawn by a woman from the future.
Uh-huh.
At nighttime, the tattoos come to life and tell a story. It's pretty awesome.
These do tell a story.
Hey, Reid.
What's up?
Our man here was a prolific journaler.
With teeny tiny handwriting.
He probably had counseling at some point where journaling was part of his therapy.
That's what we were thinking.
And?
And, well, you know, the two of us, it would take us like 3 days to read all of this stuff.
You guys owe me.
Ten out here, and it feels like a refrigerator compared to that warehouse.
How's Reid doing?
Doesn't even seem to faze him. He's just sitting there in a corner, turning pages.
Yeah, Reid goes to another place when he reads.
Straight or a flush, Dr. Reid? What are you trying to fill in?
Well, considering the odds of filling an open-ended straight with one card or 5-to-1 against, well, a one-card flush draw is more like 4.5-to-1, I guess. You'd say if I was smart, drawn to a flush. I think I'm gonna go all in on this.
So, are you?
Am I drawing to a flush or am I smart?
Either.
Well, I'm provably a genius, but actually, I was drawing to a full house, eights over sixes.
I always forget you're from Vegas.
Yep.
Oh, I'm sorry, not so fast. I, too, have a boat. Jacks over threes.
Wait, you drew three cards to a full house? That's like 100-1 against.
97-1. Looks like you're out.
There is a whole nother side to that woman.
I never lose.
A whole nother side.
Rest of us should get some sleep. Start fresh in the morning.
I've got four of the upstairs rooms available.
Four?
Come on, that's the best we can do. Your team is double the size of my department. I'll see you in the morning.
Good night. Looks like we'll have to double up.
I'm not sleeping with Reid.
Dibs. Well, hello.
What, did you join a boy band?
No.
Okay, so what are we looking
at? Utterly meaningless crimes, no obvious motivation. Pure evil.
Evil can't be scientifically defined. It's an illusory moral concept that doesn't exist in nature. Its origins and connotations have been inextricably linked to religion and mythology. This offender has shown no signs of any belief. I'm Spencer Reid.
Matt Spicer.
How many cops are there in LA?
City or county?
You actually know the answer.
I know both answers.
White.
Oh, again with the dairy.
Can't help it. I love dairy.
Like what, 20?
Can you just slept in?
My alarm clock's broke.
Broken. Your alarm clock's broken.
Broken.
Our loss is somebody else's gain.
I can't just take you away.
The cool thing about Halloween is that it's a uniquely American holiday. I mean, despite its obvious origins in the Celtic Festival of Samhain and the Christian All Saints Day, it really is a melting pot of various immigrants' traditions and beliefs. It became a little more commercialized in the 1950s with trick-or-treat, and today it rivals only Christmas in terms of popularity.
All I asked was what he was doing this weekend.
You know, I'm toying with the notion of either going to the Edgar Allan Poe Shadow Puppet Theater or the reenactment of the 19th century Phantasmagoria.
I don't want to know.
Oh, yeah, you do. Phantasmagorias are these amazing pre-cinema projected ghost shows invented in France where the showmen attempted to spook the audience using science magic. And it just so happens that I have an extra ticket.
Tempting. Now, I thought Devil's Night was Halloween Eve.
You know, the moniker Devil's Night is somewhat deceiving. In Detroit, it's actually a 3-day citywide cultural phenomenon complete with masks, chaos, and costumes.
Say that 3 times fast.
Behold. Everyone has a new tablet.
You've gone paperless?
Fear not, Doctor of the Dark Ages. I went old school for your anti-technology quirk, paper files.
I was in here while Stephanie was in that one.
Okay.
Could you sit down?
Here.
All right, I can see the whole room, but I can't see my partner. If you're working as a team, you both want to see the girl you're going to take home. Why would they do it somewhere where they can't see each other?
We should take a look at the club surveillance footage.
This building has 3 exits, north, south, and west. You're here to target a woman, but you don't want to attract attention.
Well, standing in the middle, gawking at passing women would certainly attract attention, like you're doing now.
What's that?
Just like that. IQ of 187 is slashed to 60.
I was remediated in the academy also.
Agent Seaver, Dr. Reid.
What was your issue?
What was my issue? Marksmanship, physical training, obstacle course, Hogan's Alley. You know, pretty much everything that wasn't technically book-related. They ultimately had to make exceptions to allow me into the field.
Beam me up, Scotty, was never actually said. The closest they ever got was Scotty beam us up in the Gamesters of Triskelion in the Savage Curtain episode. But interestingly enough...
Reid, come on, give it a rest.
How's it going with the agent whose father was a... you know?
How'd you know that?
I might have looked into someone's hidden background. What? I am not going to let some strange new person travel with my family and not find out who they are.
I don't know, she seems fine.
What is that in your voice?
It's what in my voice?
Oh my God, you think she's pretty?
What? I never said that.
Oh, you totally do. PG out, lover boy.
This guy could be anywhere. L.A. is over 500 square miles.
498.3.
And the fact that no one has seen him either abduct or...
The cabs have GPS?
Yeah. Taxis are tracked more than Gaga's Twitter.
What does that mean?
I'll explain it to him, Garcia.
Yeah, teach him to worship the other Lady G, boss. Ta and ta. Reid?
Emily, you are not going to believe this.
No?
They're showing Solaris tonight, the original, in the theaters. You want to go?
Did Morgan put you up to this?
What?
Did Morgan tell you to call me?
Oh, Morgan have no idea what Solaris is.
So, you just called me out of the blue?
Well, I mean, the original one's in Russian, so really you and I are the only ones that can really enjoy it.
Isn't Solaris like 4 hours long?
It's five, the best sci-fi meditation film of all time, but for some reason they never really show it in the theaters. You want to go with me?
Sorry, handsome. I'm going to have to pass. I'm just going to hang out with Sergio tonight.
Oh, shoot, I didn't realize that...
Relax, Reid. Sergio is my new cat. But, thank you.
For what?
For being you.
Aw, thanks. I don't know how to be anyone else.
Yeah. That's what I love about you.
Bye.
The one where they fly around in the phone booth.
First of all, it's a police box, not a phone booth. Second of all, Doctor Who started a quarter of a century before Bill and Ted even went on their bodacious adventure. So really, they should have just called it Bill and Ted's Excellent Ripoff. I mean, at least then they would have...
I'm really sorry.
For what?
Asking.
I'm sorry.
I thought you were in there.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sure these victims overlapped. Now, Garcia pulled their phone numbers, but so far I can't find anything.
You just jumped.
I've been having these really intense headaches lately.
Have you seen a doctor?
Yeah, a few. None of them have been able to figure it out.
Oh, I'm sorry. Does anyone know?
You?
I won't tell anyone.
I know. They just worry. You know, not that you're not going to worry, but they'll just make me feel like a baby, you know?
I do.
How about you?
I'm good.
You've been picking your fingernails again.
Yeah.
You only do that when you're stressed.
It's just a bad habit.
These last four names are covers. Spies.
Wait. No, this isn't right. See, this space, I shouldn't be here.
Could it be a formatting error?
No, this is a spreadsheet template. The formatting doesn't allow for this. There's a missing name on here.
It's another spy whose cover is LR.
Lauren Reynolds is dead. Lauren Reynolds is dead.
Lauren Reynolds is dead.
What?
Lauren Reynolds is dead. Prentice said that on a phone call 17 days ago, but her intonation wasn't surprise or grief. It was like a mantra, like she was reminding herself. Lauren Reynolds, L-R.
If Prentice is the last name on that list, she's on Doyle's list, too.
That explains her behavior the past month. The secrets, the evasion.
She's been biting her fingernails again, too.
Guys.
She left her badge and gun. Why would she do that?
That doesn't make sense. Why run? We're her family. We can help.
Doyle's killing families. She's not married, not close to relatives. He was ready to wipe us out. She ran to protect us.
She never made it off the table. Spence.
I didn't get a chance to say goodbye.